Hi, I'm Laura, and I'm a member of the Chrome accessibility team at Google. In this video, we'll go over some different ways to navigate your Chromebook using just the keyboard, plus where you can learn more about some available keyboard commands. Let's get started by taking a look at the status tray menu in the lower right-hand corner of your screen. To open it, I hold down Alt and Shift and press S. To move around the menu, I can press Tab. And to go backwards, I press Shift-Tab. This menu is really useful. I can do a lot of different things here. I can connect to a different Wi-Fi network or manage my Bluetooth devices like a headset or a printer. I can adjust the audio input and output, navigate to settings, and so much more. That's the Chrome OS status tray menu. Now let's navigate the launcher and shelf in the lower left corner. Let's start with the launcher. It's the leftmost icon at the bottom of the screen. The icon looks like a magnifying glass. To jump right to it, I press Alt-Shift-L. The small color border around it indicates focus. Focus means that if I press Enter, I can activate that specific item. In this case, when I press Enter, the app launcher opens. I can search from here, install new apps, or use Tab and Enter to navigate through existing apps. To close the launcher, I press Escape. So earlier I mentioned the shelf, and the shelf refers to all the icons immediately to the right of the launcher. You can have up to 9 app icons pinned there. I can use the same shortcut as I did to get to the launcher. Now, do you remember what that was? Alt-Shift-L. Awesome. I press that, and then I can use the Tab or arrow keys to place focus on the various app icons I have pinned. Then pressing Enter opens the given app. But maybe I want to get to an app even faster. Think of the apps as being numbered. Skip the launcher icon and then start numbering from left to right. So the next one is number 1, then number 2, and so on. If I want to open the third app, Chrome in this case, I hold down Alt and press the number of its position. So I'd press Alt 3. To open the rightmost icon, which I have set to YouTube on my Chromebook, I press Alt 9. This works even if I have fewer app icons than that. Alt 9 always opens up the last one going from left to right. Next, if I want to navigate to the Chrome toolbar, I can press Alt Shift T and then use the Tab key to move around between items. To navigate to the bookmarks bar, I can press Alt Shift B as in bookmarks, and again use the Tab key to navigate among bookmarks. Last, if I want to access the Chrome OS Files Manager, I can press Alt-Shift-M as in Manager to open this up and navigate through my files. Then I can press Control-W to close it. One more thing I haven't talked about yet is context menus. These are the little menus that pop up when you right-click with the mouse. You can also open them using the keyboard. First, I find the Shift and Search keys. The Search key on your Chromebook is on the left side of your keyboard, directly above the Shift key. Now I hold down the Shift and Search keys, and I press the Volume Up button. It's the second from the right at the top of the keyboard. Or I can hold down Shift and Search and press the 0 key. Now I can use the arrow keys to move up or down in the shortcut menu. And then press Enter if I want to choose something from the menu. If I want to close this menu, I just press Escape. Speaking of Escape, it's also pretty handy for closing things like dialog boxes. To close tabs, press Control-W. So there are a lot of different keyboard shortcuts for your Chromebook, and there are a lot we didn't even cover in this video. Luckily, there's a way to look them up really quickly, so you certainly don't need to memorize them all to get the most out of your Chromebook. If there are only a few things you take away from this video, these next few are the ones to know. Introducing the keyboard overlay. Press Control, Alt, and forward slash to open it up. If you're not sure about which slash key is right, note that it also has a question mark on it. Notice how I can press different keys and key combinations to see the various shortcuts. To close the keyboard overlay, simply press Escape. One other useful thing to know is how to take a screenshot or screen capture. On the Chromebook, the way to do this is to hold down Control and press the Window Overview key. This is a physical key on your Chromebook, just above the number 6 on the top row of function keys. This will take a screenshot of the entire screen. A notification then displays on your screen to let you know that it's been captured and saved. To access your notification center at any time, press Alt-Shift-N as in notifications. The other important thing to know, of course, is how to find help and resources in our Help app. Hold down Control and press the question mark. Here's how I remember it. Help! I'm out of control. I have questions. But really, in this Help app, you can learn more about your Chromebook as well as send feedback. Or you can press Alt-Shift-I at any time to open up and submit a feedback form. Finally, I'm going to close the windows by pressing Control-W. That's all for now. To provide us with feedback or ask questions about any of the topics that you've learned today, please do join our Google group and drop us an email at chromebook-accessibility@googlegroups.com. To learn more about Google accessibility as a whole, check out google.com/accessibility. To sign up for user studies to explore new features and help shape Google products, visit google.com/usability. Also, look out for other videos about more ways to make Chrome browser and Chromebooks easier to use. Again, I'm Laura, and on behalf of myself and the Chrome accessibility team, thanks for watching.